say you want to give?
Let us pray. Gracious God, we give you thanks that our Lord Jesus has revealed you as our Father. We understand him to be your Son, and that even within the Godhead, you live as family, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We ask that you bless our collective family and our individual families as we gather here for this day. We come, I think, surprised to discover there are so many Hoseks from so many places. It's a joy, as well as an excitement to get to meet so many other folks and discover what we share in common, even though we only, at this point, we know that we are sharing a name. We ask your blessing upon our conversation and our gathering here this day and throughout the rest of the day. We pray that as a result of being here together, we would be drawn closer to one another and closer to you. In Christ the Lord, in whose name we pray. Amen.
From Bohemia originally, way back there centuries ago, and as many countries or nations were at that time, they had a church of the country, and that was it. And you had to belong to that church or had to participate in that church. You couldn't do, there wasn't any religious freedom. As you know, and you have to know a little bit about history, you know, religious freedom back hundreds of years ago, there just wasn't any religious freedom. And there were only just a few major religions, and the Catholic religion was the biggest religion, I suppose, in the world, unless you got into the Buddhists and a few of those. I don't know exactly at this point. But anyhow, the Church of Rome was the national church. Now, anything I say, I don't mean anything against anybody's church. I don't want to get crossed up in any way, please. But anyhow, the Church of Rome, as I understand it, was the Church of Bohemia at the time. Wallerstein, I think, was the emperor at the time, and there was a general, and I've even forgotten the first name right now, but it seems like James or something, but anyhow, General Hosack, and he was the adjutant. I guess he was in charge of all the army, I don't know, under Wallerstein, but he was right there, Wallerstein's right hand, and there was some little side new religions trying to break out and being stomped down all the time by these national churches in the different little countries all over the white world, I say the Caucasian world, pretty much. And anyhow, as I understand it, the followers of Huss, the Hussites and so forth, and some of the Hossacks got involved in that and apparently was trying to be involved in a little bit, and but the local people, you were not involved if you tried to cross anything of the regular church, the national church. And so they began everything throwing rocks at them, to going out hanging them and different things. They were persecuting people that were doing these things, trying to do something different than the regular religion. And so anyhow, apparently the general and Wallerstein, he's being very lenient, but his people and his nation, he had to run his nation. And anyhow, one of his sisters, I understand, married a prince or someone in England, and she was very lenient. And when she got to England, she kind of tried to open the pathway and said, look, some old people over there, they'll come on to England if they want to. Well, anyhow, the general led a group of Hossacks, and no telling who else went with him, but they went across, apparently went across Germany and France and went into Great Britain. From there, in Great Britain, some stayed in England, but many of them, most of them, went northward, and a big part of them went into Scotland. A few got into Ireland, and some later even went into Ireland, and some crossed maybe from Ireland back to Scotland, I don't know. Our group, as we have it, of our group, my group, traces back to from Scotland. But we have with us some other groups here. And here, where are you and your brother stand up? They're from Canada, from Toronto. Theirs ties back to an ancestor that came from Ireland. And I think we'll find some connections in that sometime. If we get back, you know, way back.
And Ireland. And they came
Toronto, Ontario. We were burned out by a forest fire and moved to a second location. The son they left in New York eventually settled in Dakota, state of Dakota, Dakota Territory. And then after their second place in the Toronto area, I think around about 1900, they moved to the area south of Winnipeg, which was far from Dakota Territory. In fact, most of them went there. Our grandfather, he stayed in Ontario. We have both pronunciations, Toronto area, Posset and Posset. Thank you.
I have a book that I've got to get back to you. See a picture of some things that was given me a friend who got off the internet. And then I saw his picture when he was a little younger in their book. They have a beautiful little family book that I hope that we can have several of.
I think they need that. Applause.
Where's the heritage in that?
One or two, and then
started as a horse thief.
Walls back there. We've got walls back there, and then there were several in our history. We had one from around here that married one of the prophets back
50
years ago or so. I don't think there's not any
of them.
They're all different churches.
Oh, are they all different churches?
Yeah. Different religions and everything. It probably just happened. Now, Walsey, there's more than one minister in your family, isn't there?
There's a minister. My uncle, Alan's father, was a minister. Going down on Marion with his boy. It's been back as far as I got any history on. About every other generation away from the colors has been a minister.
You're General Baptist, is that right? General Baptist. Here's our card.
We also have some others here, and Reverend David from, you talk just a second about yours like they did. They're from Pennsylvania. They came from Ireland originally.
Of course.
I think they'll tie together.
Well, as far as we know, George Hosick came to the States from Ireland in the year 1800 and settled in the Pittsburgh area where he owned land that Three Rivers Stadium now sits.
Yeah, any of you kids want to go to a ball game in Pittsburgh, Three Rivers Stadium, all you have to do is walk up there and say, I'm a Hosick now. We have the right to come on this property.
That's right.
We did a thorough title search. We happened to be in Scotland 6 years ago, and I just about fell over when I read David's book, and he traced Alexander Hosick and being born in Elgin, Scotland, which is where we were for 5 weeks. I did a pulpit exchange with another pastor, and it's a beautiful city and a delightful place. But it's in what they call Inverness Shire, which is the territory around Inverness. And so we went to the library over there one day, and did a little bit of study with the librarian. He said that many Scots, that the Hosick name was common to that area, many of them went to Ireland to find women who they married and took off to the States. And so he said that was not unusual that George Hosick could have been from the Inverness area, gone to Ireland, married a woman, and went to the States, and said most of them were either farmers or fur traders. And because George bought land along the river, they surmised that he was a fur trader. That's a lot of surmising. We don't have any data to back that up. That's what this librarian thought was a realistic assessment of.
Tell me a little bit, or tell us a little bit about the Nebraska part too. I mean, this really puzzled me.
Well, I was in Nebraska for 8 years as a pastor, and Joni and I were in the middle of the state.
Were you anything to do with that big bunch of posts out in the hall?
No, I was called there. Served two churches there. But while we were in Nebraska, we were part of a team that went around the churches to do renewal events. And we were in this one in, was that O'Neill or someplace, some small town out in the middle of the state. And the folks said, when they met me, saw my name, they said, well, you need to meet our pharmacist. His name was Jose, too. So I walked downtown, And it's rather large pharmacy for a small town. And there were three pharmacists working in the back. I could see them. And I immediately knew which one was the Hosek because he looked just like my dad and my uncle. I went right up to him, and sure enough, he was the Hosek. And we talked briefly. The only thing he knew about his family was the roots, he said, were somewhere back in Illinois.
Oh.
And he said his grandfather or somebody came out from Illinois to and by the way, the answer to the question of why there is so many ministers in his family, as a Presbyterian, I can tell you that it was predestined.
And see, the confusing thing is there's a lot of Alexanders, but not our Alexander. And some of our folks have that confused and want to tie in with that group. But there are several Alexanders, and it's hard to track records to get the right one.
I think there's about three or four Alexanders in our.
Yeah.
Three Jerry Poets and so forth.
Anyhow, the funny thing about this, there was a bunch in Pennsylvania that left Pennsylvania and went on over in Ohio, some stayed, went on over northern Indiana, some stayed, went over northern Illinois, some stayed, they went over in Iowa, some stayed, went on to Nebraska finally, and there's a bunch of them in Nebraska. And they'll poke back to this, that, and the other, northern Illinois, or different places where their dad or grandpa's, you know. But there's a lot of them came to Pennsylvania, and came across, moved across country, moved westward. And, well, anyhow, we got.
Move backwards, you just look at me.
We got. I'm going to talk this to you. What I wanted to do was show that there's a couple of groups here that aren't real close to us. But we know that somewhere back there, we got to be, you know, tied together. And it's just sometime or another we'll find those things, maybe, we hope, that somewhere down the line, somebody will be able to tie more of them together way on back there. And now most of the other people that are here are more in our group. Yes, the spelling of the name, too, was very much different at different times and different places. One of the first was Hosek, but then it's been picked up as with two S's sometimes. And then sometimes it was changed to only one, and then there's even a group of Hoseks up in Vermont and up in that area. And the name's very common up in there, but they claim they're not at all anything to do there. They were Chudzaks or something or other, but anyhow, we'll find out sometime about that. But now, getting on down the line, the best that we have from our history is that Alexander came over here, our Alexander, sometime before the Revolution War. We're thinking he was about 4 years old when he came here, was brought here. There's somebody, one of our relatives, that put on the internet that Patrick was his father from Scotland, but most of us doubt that. We don't think that's right. We think there's some other that's just not right. But anyhow, Alexander, we don't know exactly where he was, but after he fought in the war, you understand the Revolution War, and this wasn't a nation. We just gathered, the people gathered and fought the British to run them out of here so we could have our own country. And so he fought with the Virginia troops as a part of our, I'll say, the New World fighting the British. And now, there was an Alexander that did come over here as a British officer, and I've had some people tell me there's no way in the world a Hosek could be a British officer in the Revolution War. But the history I got from someone says that this Alexander came over here as a British officer in the war. But the funny thing is, he turned around and was forgiven or made the right contacts or something, and after the war, he was in New York City and had big, big, big friends, and David was his son that became the famous doctor. And the funny thing about David is he went off to England to do some study, some advanced medical study, and on the way back, on the ship coming back home from England, he met Alexander Hamilton and Aaron Burr, who were friends at that time. And he became friends with them, and they'd stand and look over the side of the ship, and they'd get together and eat together and different things. Alexander Hamilton got sick on the ship, and David, Dr. David Hosek, got him fixed up and got him straightened out real quick, and he just thought the world of him. And when he got back home, he says, "I'm going to help you, and we're going to stay close together." Alexander Hamilton's daughter, as I understand it, or a young child or something, got deathly sick, and two or three doctors said there's nothing we can do, she's going to die within a day or two. He stepped in and called him, brought him in, and he stepped in to save the child's life. Well, Alexander Hamilton just said, "You know, Lord of mercy, you're the greatest thing ever happened to me." And he worked him in through his political connections and got him to stay up close to where the American government was being formed and so forth at that time, and worked him in. And then the funny thing, when they had Aaron Burr and Alexander Hamilton had their duel, they fell out politically and crossed up, and finally they had the duel. And when they had the duel, Dr. David was right there with them to treat him, and he was shocked, so he treated him overnight until the next day, until he died. And so, anyhow, that's another branch that's not part of ours. Our Alexander, as I say, after the war up there, finally when we got organized as the United States of America, they said the only way we can pay you people is give you some land grants, pay you land. And they gave him some land. He was a tailor in Greenbrier County, now West Virginia, was in Virginia. And he gave him some land, but he'd already bought himself, I think it was 30-something acres or something, had a little home and all, and started his family. But they gave him the land grant and so forth, and he got that. A little bit later, they found out that he could go other places and get land grants. He could sell his land and move on. And he had someone that encouraged him to go into Kentucky. And so he went to Madison County, Kentucky, which is over in the middle part of Kentucky. I think Richmond, 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 is right
over. Arch, is this David's son that you're talking about?
No. I'm back on that with our Alexander.
And how far was he from David, from the Dr. David that you were?
That's nothing to do with our
fault. Oh,
I'm sorry.
Okay.
I'm sorry, I didn't. That's a different group.
Yeah.
Our Alexander then fought in the war, and after the war was a tailor in Greenbrier County, Virginia. Got him a little piece of land, built him a house. Then the government was organized, and they got around where they could, and they gave him deed. My own 200-400 acres, I got it down. And then, after a while, someone encouraged him to come into Kentucky that he could get, because they had settlers in there. And if you were a veteran, on this part, I think, you could come in there and get it easily if you show responsibility. So sold his property for a little bit, went down there. Lived there a while. Some of the daughters got married there and stayed there. And somebody helped us get in touch with them some way. There were no men apparently stayed there. So, but anyhow, they were there a little bit. And his wife's folks settled right over here somewhere in Livingston County across the river. And they encouraged her, she wanted to go down and said, "Look, they opened up a new bunch over there. You come in there and get a settler's grant now." So he sold his land up there. And I believe his sons had some land up there too with him. And they also came over and settled down the river here about 15, 20 miles above to Birdsville.
Probably.
Yeah. Burnaby, a little bit of town, wasn't anything then, wasn't a town then, but you built a place supposedly up over the river, overlooking the river and so forth. And so, then, after he died, three of his sons, his three sons, and one of them was Alexander Jr., went off to White County up here because they did not want to be involved with what was developing toward the Civil War. In other words, all this argument about slavery and everything, and they just did not want to be involved in it. So they found out they could go up and get some land, and I think they bought, but very got a discount or something through the government, bought land in White County. One of them stayed in White County, one of them went back to Kentucky, and ours was on the way back and got here in Hardin County, and they just said, I'm just not going back. I will build you a house here. There's the river. You can see the river. There's Kentucky across the river. We'll go visit once in a while, but we're going to stay here. I don't want to be a part of that. And so that's how come we have some people here today from Kentucky and some people here from White County. Even I don't care if you live in St. Louis or where you live, or California, wherever, I'll call you White County. Hardly you know what I'm talking about.
What was the name of the one that's
on the river?
There was Alexander Hosick lived there. Some of his he died there. The old house has been torn down just a few years ago. They moved to the cemetery now. I haven't got to go there yet, but I will in a little while if I can stay able. But I think part of his maybe one or some or something you want to have prayer for. They went to Pirate Ridge down there. But,
Enfield.
Pardon?
Enfield.
Enfield, yeah. For the Pirate Ridge, but Enfield. I knew Herschel. I was real friends with Herschel, the minister. I met him in Indiana years ago, my little family, several years ago. But, I don't know any farther back than that. I want to say this to the Hosicks especially. My granddad, Duke Hosick, he evidently believed in the Hosick family tree because he had 11 kids. he was married three times. He had two children by his first wife, two children by his second wife. His first wife, Tobin Lewis, and there might be somebody here from Illinois that would know Will Humphrey. Lives on me. They live above Mount Vernon. But they're gone now. Then his second family was Barnett Hosey and Lee Hosey. They're both passed away. And then his third wife, they had seven children. My dad, and cousin back there, Alan's dad, George Hosey, Grant Hosey, George Hosey, and Jess Hosey, Carl Hosey, Henry Hosey, and Nori Hosey, because his family, they're all gone. And but we all live over in Livingston County. About all of them. My Uncle Jess, he died down here at Gulf College just a few years ago. And Carl was in Jacksonville, Florida, or Orlando, Florida, I think it was, when he passed here. Uncle Henry, he died in St. Louis. Uncle George lived in Lower Kentucky. Dad lives in Lower Kentucky. He passed away. He's been gone about 12 years. He was 91. My mother was 86. And they lived together right up until he passed away. Didn't have to have anyone take care of another. One went to the kitchen to cook the bowl.
The niece. My daddy was mean. Their grandfather, what do you do? His father was William Barnett, and his mother was Mary Cole. I don't know if that helps you any. They had William Duke, Sarah Elizabeth, Mary Ann, and James Alexander. And then his parents were Alexander and Elizabeth Robertson, and they had William Barnett. So I don't know if that helps anybody think about how we're tied in. And Alexander, his parents, that Alexander, because like we said, there's quite a few.
Will you be Alexander Jr.?
Yes, Alexander Jr., who was married to Elizabeth. Then there, his father was William H. and his wife Polly Turner, and that's what we tie into the ones in Illinois. So I just wanted to tell them that. That's how we, four generations back for us, is how we're tied.
Grandma's Turner.
Okay.
Are there any others from Kentucky who want to say something about your... I'll say this about the old place at Birdsville. We have a letter and some information and some of the things we have that come back that a fellow said when he grew up over there around Birdsville, and he wrote this letter. He was a little boy and so forth. He remembered the old house, but nobody was living in it then. They had gone. But he said that it was a big two-story log house, I believe it was. It had a big chimney at each end of the house. Was high over the river, and said that it was also that they got paid a little payment from the government for hanging a lantern over the side of the cliff at night so the boats up and down the river could see it for navigational purposes. And somewhere since that time, there's been a little earthquake that shifted the land a little down there, and I'm not sure now the river sweeps a little different than what it did then, but anyhow. Also, and it's been mentioned, I've had a lot of Joe Hosicks in the family too.
And it's quite obvious that we all come from the same source. We wouldn't have so many Franks and Joes and Georges, but they didn't have a lot of names apparently. Just use the same ones all over. I don't have too much to say about our family history because I can't go any further back than my grandfather, who was Frank. And so apparently he come from James, that pattern there. I heard he came from this neck of the woods, but I'm not sure. The gentleman there just mentioned Herschel, that was my uncle. He was a minister, no doubt about that. About as hard shell bad as you get. You stare me right now quite often. Any of your members of my family, we all come from Enfield. Some of them are still there. And some of us have moved on. Some of these people over here got roots in Enfield too. And they might speak for themselves. That's my uncle's wife sitting there, for example. Her children. This is my brother Tom over here.
And Tom Spade.
And our dad didn't believe in extending this tree that this gentleman was talking about. But he got married twice. He ran real fast and got divorced. He married Tom's brother and had him, and he saw him, so that better be it too. We're both pretty nice little guys. I don't know what he saw. Anyhow, this is Charles here. He's a cousin of mine. His wife was aunt sitting here. Huh?
My
mother might not like that. She objected to Michael Redling. But that's all I got to say.
Well, let me ask you this. One thing, I've got a sheet of names on it. People's names they like to be called. And have never seen anything like it. Babe Jr., but he just goes right on, you know, down to everybody's.
Well, there's only one thing. It's
a nickname.
I was going to say, the only one thing was an infield. You didn't have a nickname, you didn't have a complete name. I don't know whether that's in a Hosick tradition or not. But there's my cousin sitting way back there. I just recalled his nickname, and it's been back in my memories there somewhere.
Spuds.
No, you're not Spuds. Oh, you're Bolo. You're Bolo. Your dad was Spuds. Mine was Dago, and I don't know. You just had to have one, and everybody's got one. And my brother over here, he's Black Cat. They all had one until they left home, and then a lot of them, when they got older, they didn't like to be remembered that way. I ran into a guy that was couple of years older than me, and he got downright mad at me for referring to him as a nickname, so I quit that. Anyhow, we're the White County bunch anyhow, and some here and there. That's one over there from White County too. Bobby. Okay, that's all I
Howard, that's all right.
Sounds right.
I said, that's all right.
Well, that's what my dad wanted him.
He was supposed to call Billy for him.
My name is Howard. My dad wanted to name me William when I was several years.
You used to drive a truck?
No. I worked in Caterpillar.
You worked for Ralph Holdenkey?
Ralph's my brother.
He's the guy I gave a deal with.
He's my brother, but he's not in very good health. He couldn't be here today. His wife is not in very good health. She couldn't be here today. She had a. It's possible she's going to have a hard time passing. So he's got lung cancer. He just is likely he can't travel real awful well. But we're hoping the things turn out for the better. And there was something else I was going to say, but I got sidetracked over something or another. Can't remember what it was all about now. I'll probably remember it before the day's over. Oh, I forgot to introduce my wife here. She'll get to me. You forgot.
I wonder why she went to
She'll let me know about it. She'll let me know about it. This is my granddaughter over here. My dad never told us a whole lot that I didn't know until this is not. But now my dad had a brother, Quince Alexander. Another Alexander in the family. And Anna. I guess it was just the three of them in that family when we grew up. So that's about all I can tell you. I don't know a whole lot about our family, just our immediate family, most of it.
Herman Hosey.
Well, anyhow, he's talking about Herschel Hosey being the Herschel minister. It just reminded me of Herschel being the minister. Well, he's a cousin to my dad. And Henry Hosey, just somebody mentioned, was a cousin to my dad. But he grew up in Benton, or was over there, right? Around Benton. Henry was. Henry and his wife had a slug of kids, too. So I don't know what, I forget who they say with it. His Branson family came from
her. It was like you.
He called him every name that she could possibly think of all the time. They live in an old house. I know this is not part of the deal, but they had a dirt floor. Now, y'all remember the Mammy Yoakum? Well, Edabelle's mother was, we called her Aunt Mag. She was bent, had them old high top shoes on, what have you. She was a perfect second for Mammy Yoakum. Edabelle and her lived in a house together, and Uncle Charlie or Zip would come across the tracks and take care of all this and go back down to his house. All of you from Southern Illinois, a few years ago, they always used to have down here at El Dorado, they had a chicken hatchery. And one of the things you heard on the radio every morning was buying your Lager, all these big special, they'd have some. Guy with a guitar playing, Cowboy Yoakum or Cowboy this or what. Well, this country song called I'm Thinking of You Tonight, Blue Eyed or something was popular then. And Aunt Mag, she had a big old cane like Mammy Yoakum. And she just bought her first table radio, battery operated, Philco. It's reported that one morning this chicken hatchery was calling this guy to sing, and Aunt Mag decided she wanted to hear Blue Eyes. Of course, she didn't get her request, but that was just what she wanted to hear. And she knocked that radio right off the tabletop of that cane and tore it up, so she didn't get Blue Eyes. Besides that, I was delivering newspapers at that time. Neither one of them could read. But I sold two newspapers every day.
The little ones are all out there now.
What are you talking about? Stage one.
Those of you, Joe, I've mentioned to my brother-in-law Kenny lives in up near St. Louis, Creve Coeur, Missouri. And my brother-in-law, Larry Hosek, lives in Columbia, Illinois, near me. And my brother-in-law, Merle, just was buried about a month ago. He was in Flippin, Arkansas, and died of, started colon cancer and metastasized to the liver. My husband's been dead 8 years, and he died of lung cancer at the age of 58. Merle was just 59. Yeah, all sons of Charles, which was Abe Hosek, who was married to Myrtle Faye, which maiden name was Dennis.
Which I found out yesterday, you know why Grandpa was called Abe? Do you know why my grandpa was called Abe?
No.
Because he used to play Abraham Lincoln every year in the school.
But you know what?
Mr. Rumler, Rumler's Pharmacy told me that.
But you know what, honey? Bill just told us yesterday that he didn't go to school past the third grade, so that couldn't have been true. He must have just played it in town plays.
No, he played it in the school as an adult.
Oh, okay.
Well, that doesn't seem like Grandpa.
Well, Grandpa...
But his name wasn't really Charlie, it was Elvis.
Grandpa drank a lot when my children were small, and that's probably why he said that. But he was a very, very fine, honest person, and I've always heard that that's why Grandpa was called Abe.
Pardon me?
Honest Abe. Yeah. But his name actually was Charles Elvis.
Is Jonathan here? Ray and Pat, are you here? Or did Ray and Pat leave? Did Ray and Pat leave? Hey, did Ray and Pat, are they out there? Ray and Pat and Jonathan were out there. Bubby is going to talk with us. Stephen Turner Hosek is going to talk with us about the Hardin County group. Our group.
I look around the room and I see. Well, it looks like my grandfather and his brothers. And it's just remarkable how the looks and family is just toned down from generation to generation. Remarkable. It's a pleasure to have all of you here in our county. Also, this makes the second year we've had the reunion here, and we'd love to go somewhere else next year if somebody else would like to be the host. Branch or host group, we'll be glad to go to your visit you and see your father's family's history. My name is Stephen Turner Hosek. I'm the second born and the only son.
I don't know how those nicknames got down here, but nickname Bubby.
I'm Bubby and Buddy back there. I'm the second born and the only son of Joseph Lawrence Hosek Jr. I have three sisters, Janet, who's married to Scott Bowler. They live in Evansville and have two fine sons and two fine daughter-in-laws and one grandchild already. I have my next younger sister, one that will be here today apparently, who lives in El Dorado. She has three beautiful children and has been blessed with how many grandchildren? Yeah, one or two, two or three, three or four grandbabies. My baby sister and her husband also live in Evansville. They're unable to be here. They have some family health problems in his side of the family. And my grandfather was known as Lawrence Hosek, Joseph Lawrence Hosek, Sr. He was one of, eight or nine children? And I don't know which where he was born in the group.
We stand on the hillside of Southern Illinois.
Yeah. Go on.
Long way down there.
cameras, I can see that. Those are the tops of the trees.
Have barges loading over there. We have one that is loaded over there. On the Kentucky side of the Ohio River. On the 6th of July, 1998. The Ohio is very muddy. And we're still standing way up here.
Oh yeah, it's muddy, right?
A little hazy. Humidity is very high. I'm sweating. Chris is perspiring because women don't sweat.
Looks like a statue. Comes a car. Hope you don't run this way.
The car, that's the barge. He ain't real scared of us.
No, he's not. He's wagging his tail.
Go over there and stand by him. Makes you feel kind of small, don't it? Say, here, Bambi, Bambi, Bambi.
Oh, any bright lights?
Yeah, see, look, there's a feeder.
Oh.
I don't know if that's for the deer or what. Go ahead, dive in.
Well, say something, don't just stand there.